What the hell's going on here? Oh my god, I'm hungover to begin with. I gotta deal with this. Oh yeah, so what's going on there, Preach? How we doing today?
I'm dying, brother.
You're dying, I'm hungover. How you doing, Lorenzo?
I'm doing just fine, man.
Oh, good, somebody's doing all right. So many things in the news.
Wait a minute, we're actually on?
Yeah.
We're on right now, yeah.
Oh my god.
I mean, doesn't feel like it.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't. I think we're trapped somewhere.
I think I'm trapped somewhere. I feel that.
Don't bring up the wormholes again, man.
No, but why is this thing not working? All right. Well, listen, there's so many things in the news. I mean, I want to start off with, there's been a thing in the news lately. They're asking people, am I slurring my words or am I all right?
I think I can.
A little bit of a slur. I'm hungover, man. I drank a lot last night. But you know why I do that sometimes.
When you do that, though, you need to bring a translator. So, you know.
Oh, that's what I'm here for.
Really? Yeah. I didn't know that.
Somebody's going, what is going on? My God, just hit me in the head with a hammer already. Oh, my God.
Wake him up.
Well, listen, I mean, there's been a lot of, in the news, people are talking about how come in this day and age, you know, there are more, and it's, you always have the cases where you have the student who sleeps with the teacher, you know. Usually it's a man who sleeps with some young girl, and people get all upset.
No.
But lately, the big thing is, they're saying, how come all these hot female students are getting arrested for sleeping with students?
Not the students, the teachers.
The teachers are getting busted for sleeping with their students. So I'm thinking, you know, my opinion is, I think it's Facebook. I think these kids are going on Facebook, they're bragging. It's like, yo, I'm banging Mrs. So-and-so, you know, and, social studies or whatever. And they're talking about it in detail. And what's happening now is the kid who's not getting laid, he's running over and he's calling the cops.
You're wrong, man.
Yeah,
I think it's the teacher. Isn't the parents?
No. You know what I know? Because we talked about this before. Because this is a real serious problem. Because the thing is this. When we were growing up, if you had a chance to bang a teacher, I mean the hot one, you never, I can't imagine any one of us in our generation saying a thing. It would be mum's the word. But now, to your point, everybody wants to brag about it. It's usually the kid who's lucky enough to be getting banged who does the talking. And they blab, they put it out there, and the wrong person sees it.
But the guy who's jealous is the one who's calling the cops.
I don't know about that. I think the wrong person sees it, whether it's a parent, it's got to be a parent or some administrator. Or one of the other kids tells his parents, and then the parents say, hey, you know, these two guys who got involved.
It's terrible.
I mean, these kids nowadays, you hear about them, like they break into houses, and they trash a house, they do all these crazy things, and they film it.
And they post it.
They film themselves, like, breaking in places and trashing things. I mean, listen, if you're jumping off the Twin Tower, off the Empire State Building, or the World Trade Center, or something like that, and you're parachuting down, I can see filming that and posting that on Facebook.
Yeah, but still going to get arrested.
You're still going to get arrested.
You're still going to get arrested.
They got it, you know.
Well, I think, you know, every generation talks about the generation, you know, after it as being just nuts. But I think this generation after us really is, and look, perfect
trend. I think it's the drugs.
Oh, no. I don't know.
Where drugs come into it?
Look at this. This kid, also in the news, this kid, girl turns him down for the prom.
Okay.
So he kills her.
Oh, that was the kid I heard about that.
He kills her.
What?
You know what that kid is? That's the kid who wasn't allowed to play dodgeball.
Yep.
Right? That's the kid who got the trophy for coming in eighth. And then all of a sudden, he has this weird sense of entitlement, thinking he's special. He asks a girl out. She says no. I'm like, dude, listen to me. You will be rejected for the rest of your life by hot women. You will be. So to start at 16, and she's not even hot. So you're gonna kill, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, like, dude, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? If we killed every single woman that said no to us.
Oh my God.
The whole thrill of it was, to me, it's like, I don't know. I mean, it'd probably be a little bit nice, but I mean, if every woman in the world just said yes and wanted to sleep with you, I mean, it would probably get boring after a while, right? I mean,
no, it wouldn't.
No, it wouldn't at all. No. It sounded like really ethical and really nice.
No. Now, on the bright side of things, if all men...
It's like a challenge. It's like hunting. If every deer you shot got killed, I mean...
But listen, there's a bright side to it. Imagine if every man agreed that they would kill a woman that said no. Every woman, therefore, would start saying yes.
That would definitely happen. I mean, women would be afraid. I mean, they'd probably just hide themselves. We probably wouldn't see the really good-looking ones.
We don't see a lot of good-looking ones along
the way. Unfortunately, we're not seeing a lot of good-looking ones these days, anyway.
Hey, you know, I don't know what you guys, you know, I got a good looking one in my house. I don't know what you guys
are. Yeah, all right.
I mean, look, listen, I'm not talking about the ones that we have in house. I'm talking about the, you know, the herd.
It depends. Well, it depends
where you go, man.
Yeah, the community
you
hang
out
with.
Depends where you go. I mean, if you're going out to certain bars, I mean, but bars have been the place. I want to talk about, have you been watching the whole thing in Clive Bundy Ranch?
Yeah. You're talking about the guy, the rancher, and the...
The rancher and the Land Bureau Management, LBM, or Bureau of Land Management.
I started to watch it, but go ahead. This is your militia thing.
Well, this was the whole militia thing. I mean, now, I mean, at first it seemed like it was an open and shut case of the government just being abusive and, you know, going to this guy's place. I mean, people stood up to him. People stood up to the government, and they said, no, you can't take this guy's cattle. I mean, he's been leasing the land since, like, 1870 and all that. And I guess,
he's
like,
pretty old, though.
Well, his family's been leasing the land. And he's had, they had grazing rights where, okay, we own this much land right here, but our cattle's allowed to graze on all this land over here. The government came in and said, no, you can't do that anymore or whatever. That was a story. Now, from what I'm hearing, is that basically the guy was told back by Ronald Reagan, in Ronald Reagan time, you know, that if you're going to graze here, you have to pay a certain amount of taxes. So it's been over 20 years worth of time.
So he hasn't paid taxes.
He hasn't paid taxes. And the guy has said, listen, I've got guns and all that. You come here to try to take my cattle, I'll shoot you and all that. So now it's very iffy. I mean, was this guy right? Was he wrong? I'm not 100% sure who's right or wrong here. At first, it seemed very open and shut. The government was abusing their power. That I guess that they were going to sell the land to the Chinese for some solar power thing, but now as I read it, it's almost a reverse, conspiracy theory. It's almost a reverse conspiracy theory where usually you hear the stuff and it's the government who's doing a conspiracy theory. Now it's almost like a reverse of that, where the government's actually Joe's just doing their job. I mean,
But he owed taxes. Okay, so what do you do? You get 100 snipers, SWAT, and Rangers come in to collect the debt.
Well, really?
I mean, look,
that's what they were trying to do.
No, but the government's not stupid. If we owe that money, they would just walk up to us or send us a letter.
Well,
saying,
they did.
Saying, okay, so what? But what the government
says, no, also, I'm not paying.
But what the government also knows is that they've done their research on you. They understand it. He's the kind of guy, if you walk up to him and try to collect or just tell him something, he's probably going to pull out on you.
He said straight out, I'll shoot you.
All right, then. So you're not going to send one or two agents to come collect this guy. And you know that this guy hangs out with other crazy militia guys who like to wear fatigues and talk about government conspiracies. So there's going to be a collection of them. There's a bunch of LJs there. So they're not just going to go in two at a time. They're going to go in strong. And my thing is this. Listen, whether or not you think the tax is right or wrong is irrelevant. I'm going to tell you what a cop who arrested me said to me before. He said, I agree with what you did. No one gives a shit.
Still against the law.
Right. Exactly.
Still against the law.
Exactly.
Well, I think the deal was with this guy, I mean, where he had his right, where he felt he was right, was that back in 1870 when they bought the land and they had the grazing rights, they weren't supposed to be able to tax them. I guess Reagan changed the law 20-something years ago. And
30?
It says from 30 years ago, saying, okay, from now on, anybody who's grazing has to pay a tax. There's a grazing tax. This is in Clark County, right outside of Las Vegas. So, I mean, the land there, I'm sure, is you know, a premium. It's a desert, but, I mean, Vegas is spreading out. So, I mean,
you got to pay the tax, bro. Just pay the goddamn tax.
I don't want to pay taxes. Nobody wants to pay taxes.
I mean, look, I've been dealing with the IRS for weeks, even though those bastards owe me money. But, you know, the thing is, this is what it is. So just do it and get it out of your life and keep it moving, man. It's like having sex with your wife when you don't want to. You do what you got to do. Keep it moving.
Get the job done.
Exactly. God damn it. Man,
I guess you know what I'm saying, basically. The founding fathers made laws like that. So, I mean, actually against this guy. So there's another thing, too, now. I mean, I guess there's been a problem lately. I mean, we know we're living in an age where it's different. It's a lot different in this day and age, the past 10 years, since 9/11. Than it was when we were growing up, you know?
Oh, yeah.
There were certain things you could do, you can get away with, you could be funny. But I guess now there's been like a craze lately where, I guess it was right here on Long Island, some kid called in like a bomb threat. He was playing on those video games where you shoot everybody and you kill everybody. And so he calls in to the police station and says, gives an address. Somehow he got an address of someone he was playing against and he didn't like the guy. And he called in, so he's playing like for a war, you know, World of Warcraft or whatever. And somehow he gets this guy's address. They don't know how he got it, but he was able to get it. And they called in saying that here's this guy, and he's shooting. This is what I heard. He's shooting people and killing everybody. But now, meanwhile,
he killed his mother or something like that.
He killed his mother.
Did he do that so he could get points on the game?
No. I guess so. This guy, I don't know.
They're trying to outdo each other.
They're trying to outdo each other.
He can get the biggest SWAT response.
But I guess they said they spent, what, like $80,000 or something like that?
The SWAT team approached the house and everything. The kid was in the shower when they busted down the door. He's like, what? What happened? What'd I do?
There are jokes to be made, man. But now in this day and age, man, you really, you can't be playing that joke.
See, this is not a 1980s John Hughes life anymore. You can't do a Ferris Bueller and think you're going to get away with
all that stuff, man. All that stuff.
I mean, I think it's funny. I mean, look, I went to college, and one of the things that you always knew during finals was bomb scares. If someone didn't study, someone was calling in a bomb.
Someone was pulling the alarm switch. You know?
Exactly. Now it's a federal offense if you do something like that.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
What you even say? I mean, you can't joke around. I mean, you sit there, you're on a plane, you're like, oh, I got bombed last night. They're fucking you up, man. You're done, man.
One of my friends, we were joking around about it. I was like, man, we actually have to study now. You just can't call in a bomb threat.
You want to hear something funny? I was taking helicopter flight lessons back way before 9/11. I think it was, had to be the mid-90s or so. And I used to work at AB Plaza. You know, the two glass buildings over there, off the SAG, off the Meadowbrook. And I flew over to there, and I took the helicopter. I hovered right outside the building, like less than maybe 50, 100 feet away. I took a picture of myself in because it was reflective.
Oh, really?
I took a picture of myself in the window. And my friends, my coworkers saw me. Can you imagine doing that today?
Oh my God,
I'd be shot down.
Oh, yeah. And we'd be arrested just for knowing you.
It was great. It was awesome.
All you hear lately in the news is those laser pointers. I mean, guys are getting, I've played with laser pointers. I mean, you shine them around and all that. How come it doesn't hurt me when I shine it at my face 2 inches, 2 feet away? But if you shine one up at an airplane,
there are different intensities of laser pointers.
Yeah.
And air traffic control sometimes uses the lasers to tell pilots what to do if their communications are down. There's certain, you know, flashes and such that if communications are down, they flash the pilot. So that this way they know what to do, go around, start land, whatever it is. They're laser cannons is what they are.
Cannons.
I mean, they have sufficient.
That's awesome.
Well, they have sufficient intensity to get the pilot's attention and to do certain things. Now, that's air traffic control. When you're using it to disrupt a pilot, obviously, in the sky, that's a lot more significant, a lot more dangerous.
You know a lot about this stuff, huh?
I used to fly, bro.
We need to do a background check on this guy.
Yeah, what are you doing, man?
I used to fly helicopters as a hobby. I had a student pilot's license, and it was a blast, man.
Have you been in his room? Does he have bombs and
I cannot confirm or deny anything.
Oh shit, though, man. It was a great hobby.
I've never been in his room.
It was a great hobby, man. Flying a helicopter is awesome.
I've never been in a helicopter. I would like to go in a helicopter. I like to fly around the island.
It's a little
man.
Tricky.
It is. It's a little tricky. I mean,
I've been on planes. I mean, is it scary?
Helicopters.
There are weight limitations, which kind of precludes me from going into a small Robinson again.
Oh, really?
There's a center of gravity kind of thing that you can't fly like this. It's shot, man. But, you know.
Get drunk and fly a plane. Oh, we got a commercial? I see the hands waving. Which commercial are we doing first?
Whichever one you like. Hey, look at that. I know that guy.
Oh, all right.
That is not me.
That's not you, but that's a guy.
I do not look like that.
No, you don't look like that.
You got to let me redo the logo for you.
Yeah, would you mind?
I just found it online, man.
Did you find that?
Yeah, they'll throw this up there when we do.
You know what?
It's just something to throw up there when we read Lorenzo's commercial here.
Don't worry. We'll do something better.
We got you here in the house and all that. I mean, listen, while you're here today, let's, you know, tell us some things about yourself and your company.
Let's see.
Why don't you use you over other people?
I am the founder and the sole proprietor of Home Base Technologies. I've been doing computer work since PCs made their debut back in, the late 80s?
Wow.
I did computer. I used to take apart computers, put them back together, and it's evolved since then. So if anybody old school people know DOS and floppy disks and all that stuff, that's from how far ago. How far away and how long ago
it's
I've...
like Croft Superstars.
Yeah.
You're going
back. Baby. Yeah, it's been a long time. So I know my way around. I've been doing a lot of computer work since then. I've taught on computers and, I just know what I'm doing. And that's why my clients really like me.
I just know what I'm doing.
Know what I'm doing.
What better recommendation is that?
And you have to, because there are a lot of guys and a lot of technicians and a lot of companies that come onto the scene and they, they charge... You know, not a lot of money, but they charge. And if they don't know how to do things, you're charging twice for the work that they're doing when you can, simply get a guy in and knows what he's doing, fix it up, get it done, and you're over and done with it.
The one thing I always like is you tell me the stories. Like, you're down in Florida at Disneyland and all that on vacation. And mm-hmm. I mean, meanwhile, the people are calling you up.
Yeah.
And you're actually on your laptop. And and you're fixing their computers.
Oh, my God.
While you're on vacation.
Yeah. I have select clients, and if they need help, I'll help them out. I answer the phone calls anytime, day or night, vacation, weekend. That's just the kind of company I like. My clients, the majority of them, have been with me for over 10 plus years.
That's crazy. Good business.
All my clients been with me for over 10 years, just about.
All right, you covered the greater New York City, Long Island, Westchester areas. Homebasetechnologies.com. Is the website people can find you at, the phone number they can call you at?
631-338-0281 or 212-888-TECH. That's 8324.
All right, man. Well, listen, check them out. If you guys have any computer problems here, I know right here you got some computer problems. I mean, listen, they were asking for some help here. Everybody's always asking. I get people, too, now, and they know I know you, and they know what you do, so they come up to me and they say, hey, listen, you think I ask Lorenzo if he would help me? And I go... I'm sure you could ask him. I mean, he'd probably help you. I mean, whether he charges you or not, it's a different story, you know?
You know, I had some guy call me up at like 8 o'clock in the morning one day because his laptop wouldn't come on. So, I walked him through helping out and diagnosing.
Plug it in. How many times?
Plugging and getting a memory chip.
How many times is that something simple, right?
Well, the thing is, you need that expertise to find out what the problem is.
I knew
by the sounds. I said it sounds like a memory problem. Sounds like a memory. We moved the memory around, over the phone. Yeah. I walked preach through. Doing something.
Yeah, he was doing something.
What's this?
I don't know. What does
that
mean?
End commercial.
Was that the Bengals?
Is that end commercial? Is that what that means?
I don't know. But yeah, preacher, testify.
Yeah, Lorenzo did. I would actually allow this guy around my computer, and I have porn on it.
So, oh, really? Yeah.
And I'd allow him around it.
Yeah, I'm a professional, man. It's just like being a doctor or somebody like that sees your private stuff, man. It's I don't want to say it's old hat, but it's professionally handled.
Well, there was a show just a couple weeks ago, that new show. It's the three guys and they work for an ambulance. They're working in an ambulance.
Oh, yeah,
driving around.
Yeah.
You seen that?
No, I haven't.
And
seen
I guess they get this guy and he's sick. He has a heart attack or whatever, and he goes there. What are you pointing at? Madhouse?
I think that's the one that's actually broadcasting.
Why is
and,
it there?
And the one. Look at the CCTV.
I don't know what's going on here. We've lost control.
You need to have that laser to point you where you need to be looking.
But on the show, the guy says to him, he says, do me a favor. He's got to go to the hospital. He's like, go back and erase my browsing history. So the guys are like, what? And they're like, he's like, listen, he's like, before my wife gets home, I need you to go back and erase all my browsing history from my computer. So the three guys are like, okay, we'll do it for you.
Right.
And they don't show you what he was looking at, but they go back then. They're all like scarred for life now. They're like, oh, So I don't think
erasing your browsing history doesn't necessarily let you see what's there. It erases
well,
it.
Well, they went so back, and whatever the guy was looking at was the last thing, and it was pretty funny. It was a pretty funny show, I mean. But speaking of TV shows, I want to say, listen, a lot of my favorite shows have come to an end this year. I'm a big fan of the show How I Met Your Mother. Right. You watched it all. I really liked it. That ended. Psych was probably one of my favorite all-time shows, and that ended. I mean,
I liked House of MacGyver.
Yeah, MacGyver was always good.
I love MacGyver.
But they're ending a lot of shows this year. I don't know what it is. I mean, it's just,
the
shows that are coming out, it's tough getting into a new show. It's like dating a chick, you know? Okay, are we back? I don't know what's going on here. I do not know what's going on. I never do, but I'm just even more confused.
Stop smoking
crack. But it's like, yeah, well, look, they sure had some crack. But crack in the morning, nothing better. But you know what? It's like you get involved in a show. The new TV show starts, and you're like, you know what? All right. And you start watching the show, and you get into it, and all of a sudden they cancel it.
That's not. But dude, How I Met Your Mother and that other Psych was on for like they were on for a long time. You had enough time to be with them.
No, they were. We had a good relationship in those shows. I'm saying it was a good relationship, but it just. And now I got to find something else to fill the void. You know.
Look, bro. If you really want to talk about pain, there used to be a show on HBO. It was like their only happy show, which was the First Detective Ladies Agency, something like that. Had it one season, great, and it's just one of those feel good shows. One of the few they had. Then it's gone. One season, gone and out. And I'm like, all right. But I was, you know, what I like about shows now, is remember growing up, you never knew when it was going to get canceled. All of a sudden, and it killed you because you were like, oh, it's gone. But now they'll tell you like 2 years ahead of time, the show's going to end at this point. So you look forward to it.
So you're watching it.
You know what I mean? And you have certain relationships with shows that end and it kills you. Like for me, the end of The Wire is still very traumatic for me. I have a hard time with that. But then you have shows like 24 that went out, and then they're bringing it back.
I like 24. Yeah,
well, that's a little weird, too. Now they're bringing 24 back, but it's only been 12 episodes.
Yeah.
Which is good.
Double time.
But you know what? Every episode, if you remember,
double time.
The old shows, you can watch like Gilligan's Island. Gilligan's Island was on for so many years, but then they do like TV
specials,
movies.
Yeah.
TV movies, like an hour long or 2 hours long, and they'd have a special and all that. You don't see that very much anymore.
Yeah, that's few and far between.
Yeah, is that because you think the actors nowadays are just conceited, they want too much money? I mean, look at Seinfeld. Seinfeld was a good show.
They're bringing it back.
Are they bringing Seinfeld
back? He's bringing it back.
Oh, look at that.
He's going to do, like you said, he's going to do a special. And they teased it during the Super Bowl. They got them all together.
Oh, I saw them. They were walking. I saw Seinfeld was walking down the sidewalk.
And he was in the cafe with Jerry. George.
Yeah.
So they teased it. So they're doing it. So I think it also depends on a couple of things. Number one, are the actors making enough money? Do the actors get enough? Are they busy?
What is the popularity of the show too? You know, I mean, you could go out and be the number one show like Seinfeld was, one of the top rated shows. But then you come back like 10 years later now, are some people just sick of you because they're watching your reruns or something?
But
I
mean, it also depends because, you know, one of the things, I watch Frasier. I still watch Frasier.
I love Frasier. It was a great
show. I would love to see an annual Frasier, what they're doing, because those characters are timeless to me.
Well, Cheers. Why can't they just do Cheers? I mean, I can't believe that show never did a TV movie, you know? I mean, that was so popular. So many great characters.
I mean, I think it also, but look, let's take it on a bigger level. Because some people are still mad that Christian Bale will just flat out refuses to do Batman again. And so.
He's good. He was a good Batman.
And so they're bringing, obviously, Ben Affleck to do it. But he just doesn't want to do it. And people are like, dude, everybody wants to see it. And he's just like, ah.
I think with the superhero thing, there's something they call the superhero curse. Like a lot of actors who play a role of a superhero.
Not anymore.
They don't, not anymore.
Because now you have actors.
It used to be.
Now you have good actors trying to be in these movies. Michael Douglas signed up to be in Ant-Man.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Michael Douglas and Tom Rudd.
I just went and saw Captain America.
And?
And I liked it a lot.
I told you it was
very good. Very high energy.
I didn't see
it.
It was good.
Very high energy, a lot of action. I mean, I was very impressed. I mean, it was not like a regular superhero movie.
No, it was like Jason Bourne with, you know, just one guy who has a shield.
Yeah, the other guy, he's got power.
You know, speaking of actors, you know, if they wait long enough, they wind up on Nick or iCarly or Cat and Sam. Yeah, because Laverne and Shirley was... My daughter watches it, obviously, Sam and Cat.
Your daughter's seven.
She watches Sam Laverne. And Cat. No. Laverne and Shirley. She doesn't know. I explained to her who Laverne and Shirley were, but they appeared on the show.
They appeared
as guests on the show. Okay. So it was pretty fast.
I was like, your daughter's watching Laverne and Shirley?
No, I never
liked that show, man.
And even, what was it, iCarly, they did escape. Remember The Breakfast Club? It was iCarly?
Breakfast Club.
One of the greatest movies of all time.
Yeah, they did a skit. Was it iCarly or was it the other one? It was Victorious? Victorious. They did a skit on, they were punished, the principal was a butthead, and they were in detention, and instead of, you know, doing the weed, they did tacos. Oh, I love this taco. Oh, you never had a taco before? And I was like, nice. They did the whole thing, man, running around the hall, nice. Sliding back and forth. It was nice. A blast. I was like, you know
old,
what this
old
is
heads,
from?
Old heads would know.
Yeah, and I said, you know what, this is from Breakfast Club.
Well, a lot of these shows, they do that nowadays. I mean, so the movies, like you go to kids' movies and all that, and they have a lot of things that only the adults would get
understand,
certain
yeah.
shows and all that. I like when they did, one of my favorites of that, I mean, when they do stuff like that was, you ever Third Rock from the Sun?
Right. I hated that
You
show.
Like that show?
I
Aliens, but man, that's good.
Well, I love Aliens and all that. I always liked that show and all that. But the father in that show,
John Lithgow,
great actor.
He's awesome.
He was, if you remember, he was the preacher in Footloose.
Of course.
And in the show, Third Rock, he starts doing the speech. I cannot allow this endeavor to take place, something that I so... I mean, I forget the whole
things
speech.
Like that
on,
are cool.
But he did that in the show, and I thought it was hilarious, man. I mean, it was just... Because you have the character was so different that he's playing.
Let's have a transition to horror, TV horror.
Okay, I'm not a big horror fan.
I think you get
American Horror Story.
Let's go into this transition here.
All right.
One of the ugliest, and listen, for a black guy to say this, and listen, anybody will tell you this, I love a beautiful white chick. I love her.
Thanks,
I love a beautiful white chick. Let's just be honest.
Oh, yeah.
One of the ugliest women on the face of the earth, Tori Spelling. She recently came out, and she's putting this on TV, that her husband cheated on her. And they're putting this on TV. They're putting their counseling. They're putting all this stuff. And I'm looking at this first for a few seconds, and I say to myself, did you really expect this? He's a good-looking guy to be faithful to you. You literally look like a horse. She looks like a horse with a silver mane.
I know who she is. I remember I was never a big fan of 90210, but I think I've watched an episode.
She was the ugly one. That's what everyone called her. She was the ugly one.
She had a really thin body, I remember. She was super skinny.
And then her face was like the size of a 21-inch Harley tire.
Her father is...
Yes, her father. Her father was mega rich.
Right.
Well, he also produced all the shows.
Yes.
So it's like, oh, we need someone to play the nerd. He'll be my daughter of the year.
My point in bringing this up is this: if your wife is ugly, and then he goes on record to say sex with her wasn't that good, so you couple the fact that your wife looks like a sexy Mr. Ed, okay, and then she's not that good in bed. Is it his responsibility to stay faithful to her?
It's like a double whammy.
Exactly. Should he?
He's married. Technically, if he's married, he should be faithful to her. Then he shouldn't have gotten in there.
Technically.
But then you realize that the ugly horse is still going to be the ugly horse.
Is it his fault? Is it his fault?
Well, he shouldn't enter the marriage then.
Is it his fault?
Well, I think he went in for the money. I mean, listen, he shouldn't have got caught. He should have been a little more careful. I mean, they got a lot of money, you know?
I mean, I was looking at her the other day, and I'm like, I literally throw holy water on the screen when I see her. She is truly one of the ugliest people I've ever seen physically in my life. And it scars me to death, man. Linda Blair from The Exorcist has nothing on Tori Spelling every day.
Tori Spelling.
I don't know. Are you looking through regular glasses?
I want to do an Oedipus and gouge my eyes out is what I want.
Really?
To do.
Yeah.
She's that ugly, brother.
Yeah, I mean,
I won't even call her up on my smartphone.
I haven't seen her lately, so I'm not sure what she's looking like, you know, but I remember she wasn't terrible, I mean, but...
Really?
I think she was terrible. I mean,
maybe you're thinking about, you know, the other blonde who looked very good, by the
way. Well, blonde was definitely hot. Yeah, I mean, she's
the other blonde looked good. I'm just saying. I'm sorry to be a Debbie Downer on that.
No, no, listen, man, listen. Ugly women are ugly women, man. They kind of ruin things for us all. I mean, you know, if they were all hot, we could have a lot more sex and be happier. All right, is we doing a commercial now?
Strippers?
Well, I guess I don't know which one you're going to. You want to do strippers?
As long as it's not Tori Spelling stripping.
Yeah. I love strippers. Not. Oh, yeah. Man, this hungover thing, man. I don't know. I got to wake up. Still like half asleep here. ILoveStrippers.net, covering bachelor, bachelorette, corporate events, birthday parties, bridal showers. They have sexy male and female dancers, novelty acts, including chunky dancers and mini strippers. Covering New York, New Jersey, Connecticut, and Long Island. They will go as far as your imagination will let them. I always want to know what that means, man. I mean, how far can my imagination go?
How far does it go?
No elephants allowed.
Too far. No animals, no animals. Call 516-753-1242 or 718-874-9644. And let's not forget that website once again, ilovestrippers.net. Oh, yeah. All right.
I get a lot of compliments for the shirt when I wear it at the gym.
I just got some new ones, yeah. I went to my brother. He was down visiting, so I gave one to him and all that. So
a lot of people love strippers.
Listen, man, you got to love them strippers. So... But, I don't know, what else, what do you got in the news? Anything over here, or?
I mean, I'm digging up a few things. I'm still trying to get over the, you know, the Tory Spelling thing.
Yeah, well, nothing like an ugly woman to ruin your morning, you know? I'll tell you, man. I want to say, I mean, listen, I don't know what kind of Star Wars fan you are. Were you a Star Wars fan?
So, all right, let's do a quick vote. Star Wars or Star Trek?
Star Wars.
I don't know. I mean, I'm a fan of both of them, so it's kind of rough.
Can we just admit that Star Trek is the thinking man sci-fi and Star Wars is idiot?
Oh, I don't know if I'd say idiot.
I will admit
that I'm an idiot, but let's be honest. George Lucas is one of the worst writers of all time. Those movies were dumb.
The first three were good, the original ones. The original three that came out were good. The other ones weren't. But the one thing here that gets me now is like Star Wars, they got three new ones coming out. Disney owns it now. So Disney.
Which means it's
going to
be good.
Well, hopefully it'll be good.
Come on. But Lucas isn't involved.
But here's the thing. Well, he's involved, actually.
He's collecting paychecks.
Lucas thought it up. How could it not be good?
I mean, because he can't write.
$1 billion.
But here's the thing now is George Lucas had decided that was it. You know, the Star Wars, there was going to be no more movies, and that was it. And he had writers. He had writers who wrote books. And there are hundreds of books. I mean, literally, I think there's like hundreds of books out there.
Comic books and
novels. And it followed the central universe, where it followed the theme. So if you were going to write a book, and I was going to write a book, and you were going to write a book about it, we all had to follow the central universe here. It's the expanded universe. Well, now with the new movies coming out, they're saying that the movies are going to have nothing to do with that expanded universe. I mean, basically, isn't that going to just destroy, like, everybody who wrote books for years?
You can't do that.
It's going to destroy that whole universe. It's going to say...
You can't do
everything.
That.
Well, they are doing it. They can't. They're saying
that, that's nuts. That's absolutely... Because I know, I mean, being a continuity freak, you cannot do that. You can't...
And that's Lucas gave him permission, too.
But, I mean, because he's cashed out. But that's the same reason why I don't buy comic books anymore. Because you stay with like Peter Parker for years.
I love Peter Parker.
You watched him grow up. He gets married. He has a kid. And then all of a sudden, new writers come in. They're like, "Yeah, we don't like that." He just woke up one day. That didn't happen.
Yeah.
And you're just like, "No, dude. I spent money on that."
Right.
I read that for years. I mean, like I said, I was always DC. I was more DC than Marvel. But I mean,
really?
Oh, who says goodness.
That? Yeah. Who says that? You just came out the closet. No one says that.
Yes. Marvel's better than DC.
Oh my God!
What's wrong with you?
Oh man, Batman is.
Hey!
Oh my God!
Aren't the best heroes? My favorite superhero lives in the DC universe, but I still realize that Marvel is better.
Really?
Yes. Why are we debating this?
Listen, when I tell him this, he just goes off. You tell him.
Do we have a rainbow flag? Where's the rainbow flag for this guy?
It's a little different. I don't know, man. Marvel, I don't know. Whereas DC was just always just I was just always a bigger fan of DC.
Nobody says that.
Yeah, nobody says
I'm
that.
I'll give the Marvel movies have been better than the DC
oh,
movies.
Oh, my God.
Yes,
but
what's wrong with you?
I was Batman, Superman, you know, Green
Lantern. I don't know this guy.
Who was better than Batman, Superman?
Spider-Man.
Spider-Man, Steve Rogers, the X-Men. I mean, what do you want to go down the list?
Oh, my God, yeah, you got the whole list.
Listen, my favorite, like I told you, my favorite superhero lives in the DC universe.
Who's your favorite superhero?
Captain Marvel.
Captain Marvel?
By far the greatest superhero ever created. However, Marvel is still better.
Yeah, Marvel's got it, man.
I'm sorry, your point. You totally derailed the entire conversation by coming out the closet this morning.
I've always been Marvel. I couldn't get into DC.
I do like DC. I do, but I'm objective enough to know who's better.
I think it lost the.
I'm not saying who's better or who's worse. When I was younger and I was a child growing up, I read mostly the DC. I really never got into the Marvel. I mean, it was just a different style, a different universe.
Spider-Man, Iron Man, Fantastic Four, X-Men.
What does that mean?
Captain America, really?
What does that mean?
I mean, you know, you got the new Superman, Batman movie coming out.
Goddamn communist.
Do you think it's going to be good? What do you think?
Do I think it's going to be good? I think that...
The Superman movie's all right.
The Superman of Steel was good. I think that they're trying to force fit based off what Marvel did so successfully. I think that the problem with DC is that they've never really understood their characters on a human level. The fact that Wonder Woman hasn't had a major film, and if you really go into the origin of Wonder Woman, she's probably one of the most vicious and violent characters that they have. They've never allowed it to go there. You have other characters like Green Lantern, you miscast that with that idiot, made that horrible film.
Yeah, that
wasn't
a good movie. Was not a good movie.
They haven't done it correctly, and Marvel had to make a few mistakes, and finally with the offset of Blade, they started doing things correctly, and then now they're rolling. Am I going to go see it? Yes, because I'm a nerd boy, but do I think that it's going to be forced? Look at the woman they got to do Wonder Woman. Look at the woman.
I haven't seen her yet.
She's skinny as can be. We're talking about, like, let's go into Nerd World for a second. We're talking about one of the few characters that can go toe-to-toe with Superman.
Yeah, Wonder Woman.
And they picked this skinny Israeli chick to play Wonder
Woman.
Really? Yes. I mean, it's just absolutely ridiculous.
I definitely think they're forced in the whole movie, because originally it was supposed to be Batman was just going to do, like, a cameo in the Superman movie. Like a 2-3 minute cameo. He was just going to happen to be there. Now it's...
We're talking about Adam West, or are we talking about Batman?
No, the character. It was just going to be Batman.
Adam West goes walking down the street. I love Stan Lee's cameos in all of the Marvel movies.
Oh, yeah.
I love... But there he is. I look for him all the time.
Yeah, me too.
He's the man, though.
Hilarious.
I mean, definitely the man. I mean, but it was just going to be... Now they're like, all right, who's better? So they're going to have Batman and Superman fighting each other.
Which is ridiculous.
I never got that.
It's ridiculous.
Whereas, you know, I always thought, like... You got Batman and Superman. Batman is like the personification of the perfect warrior human, you know, who's trained and is smart. I mean, he's both mentally and physically a warrior and trained in all these different arts. And Superman is just the Superman. I mean, it's just what we can never be. There are all these superpowers. So to have Batman fight a person who can literally, with one breath, destroy him and kill him.
I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous. I think the way that they played it in the 80s or 90s, when Superman and Batman just didn't get along, that was the way that they should just continue to play. They didn't play well. They didn't work together. They were just, Batman was like, I don't like you.
And, you don't like me, yeah.
Yeah, and then that's the way it stayed. But to have them fight, that's like, it's just silly.
Yeah, I think now they're forcing the, but now, like I said, we're talking about the fight scene in the Avengers. I
mean, which one?
Well, the one was Thor versus Iron Man. And then it gets broken up. I mean, that was a good fight. I mean, it was pretty...
Yeah, I mean, but if you go back to comic book lore, nobody on that team except the Hulk has a remote chance of standing in the room with Thor. Yeah. Nobody has a remote chance. So...
Right, I don't know how, Captain America, you know... Or even Captain America, when he had hammered down... On Captain America.
Well, that hammer, what they don't explain is that hammer can absorb blows.
Or the shield.
The shield. Right. Thor, he can actually take a punch from Superman. And it, you ever wonder why he doesn't shake? Or it's because it's vibranium. And it absorbs everything. So that's why, that makes sense. That's why it.
Oh, that's why the whole forest almost took a powder when he hit with a hammer.
There you go.
That wasn't Captain America. I didn't follow Captain America.
Spider-Man was Nerd Marvel. World. Nerd World. Yes.
Like I said, I was more DC.
The Avengers was an awesome movie. The Avengers was an awesome movie.
They got some crazy... Marvel's just doing everything now. They got this one, Guardians of the Galaxy.
That looks like trash. That looks like a bad 80s film.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure what the hell they were thinking about there. I mean, when there's a raccoon as one of the main characters and he shoots people.
Remember the bad 80s, one that's considered one of the worst movies of all? Howard the Duck. Remember that?
Howard the Duck, I remember.
One
that.
Of the, considered one of the worst.
I liked it.
Did you?
Yeah, I was like, I don't know, I was a lot younger then.
Did you really like it?
I thought it was all right.
Stop smoking crack. Jesus.
I was younger. Damn it. You are just revealing yourself this morning.
What? I can't like stupid movies.
Howard the Duck. Nobody likes Howard the Duck.
Listen, you know what? I thought it was a funny movie back then. I was younger. I was smoking a lot of weed.
He had
back
sex.
Then. I smoked.
He had sex with that woman.
Yeah, I didn't get that part. That part was a little weird. I mean,
that part was just a little weird.
That duck, though. All right. I don't get it.
That was truly one of the worst movies, and I've been watching it because I've been sick, so I've been watching a few more movies, and let me tell you, man, I have seen some bad movies the last few days, bro. I have seen some really bad.
But you think that's one of the worst movies of all time, Howard the Duck?
Bro, that is not. I'm not gonna debate it. Howard the Duck is one of the worst movies of all time.
That'd be an hour and a half. I couldn't get back.
I think it was just yeah.
I mean, are you going to tell me Masters of the Universe was good?
No.
And then you know they're making Gem now, a live-action Gem?
I never watched that either. I mean, that was
well, I would hope not.
I would hope not. Yeah,
Flash.
I mean, but it just, yeah, Flash should be coming out. So I think they're doing Flash. I mean, but now you got the Batman. We talked before, the Batman where they got Wonder Woman's going to be in it. They got Cyborg's going to be in it. I mean,
is he?
Like, yeah, I've seen Cyborg.
Well, his father was in the first one.
Was he?
Yeah, his father was in the first one.
What about the new X-Men that's coming out?
The new X-Men.
That looks
pretty
awesome too,
man.
That was based off Chris Claremont, John Byrne, X-Men 141, 142, considered two of the greatest X-Men stories.
Really?
Yeah.
And I like the idea. Like I said, you know what? We've been fighting each other for so long, and we've become, you know, the demise of ourselves. I mean, we instead of, you know, which I never got because, you know, they were both, you know, in the X-Men. I mean, both sides, you know. Both Professor X and Magneto, they both wanted the same thing, but just one wanted to kill all the humans, the other one to let the humans live.
It's interesting dichotomy.
Evolution.
Because if you talk to Chris Claremont, who orchestrated a lot of those stories, he really did base it on Malcolm X and Martin Luther King, and then the disparities. They both wanted the same thing, like you were saying.
But one was willing to go do whatever it took.
Right. You know? And the other one was willing to do a more peaceful route.
Integration.
Yeah.
So being a white guy, I'm definitely against the killing all whiteies, you know. So.
Well.
Kill all the white guys. No. I'm not against that.
Kill the white
Let's
guys.
All just get along, man. You know? All right.
My God, that was a diversion.
That was definitely.
I'm just your DC comment. We're going to talk about it off air.
I'm not saying one's better than the other. I'm not saying that.
Well,
that's not a debate. You're saying you think Marvel is better.
We are.
Growing up, I was a big fan of Batman and Superman, and I read from the DC Universe. That's what it was. I mean, I thought it was good, man.
Yeah,
I enjoyed it.
Sorry.
I didn't read the Marvels, not to say that they were better or worse, but I just didn't read them.
I'll share a very interesting, quick comic book story. Because I like to research interesting stories online. So there's a site that goes into, you know, things that you may not know about certain characters or stories. There was a character in the 40s that Captain America fought called the Black Hand. Now, listen to this. This guy became evil when his hand was cut off, and the only hand available to graft back on was a black guy's hand. So they grafted a black guy's hand onto this guy after he protested that he didn't want those evil black fingers on. And because they grafted his hand on, his black hand made him commit murder. So...
This is a
It's a real character.
How potent you guys are. It's Marvel, which is better than DC.
That's great.
The Black Hand. That's what it was in. The Black Hand. Is that awesome?
You gotta wonder today, would that be, I mean, if that would have come out today.
Oh, it's amazing.
Would that be like, really racist? Would people be really upset by that?
Oh, I read the whole origin. They showed it. I mean, and then you should have seen when they put the hand on him. He was like those evil black fingers.
That's great.
Oh, my God.
That is great.
Awesome. Just a little something.
Yeah, like blame it on my black hand.
Freak out for that.
Right?
The so black hand of death. What's up? What's up? I can just see it. I have no control.
Remember the movie The Hand?
Oh, man, was that great?
There was a movie, The Hand. And right. The hand, guy loses his hand, the hand goes around killing people.
Yeah, man.
I mean, the hand is walking around like that.
Yeah.
No, I don't know if it was a book. I saw a movie years
like,
ago.
Like, scared you at the age of five.
I've never been a big horror fan. I always said it before on the show.
That's weird, too.
I don't like horror movies. Just to me, I get angry by them. I don't think I'm afraid of them. I just get angry.
But you like UFO
stupidity?
All I can think of is when I see these movies is how come nobody has a gun? You know what I mean? You got Jason Myers coming at you like a half a mile per hour, and he's like slowly.
Wait a minute, it's Jason Voorhees.
Mm-hmm. Michael Myers, whatever.
Let's get it together.
I'm just throwing names together. You got these freaking evil people, and they always move really, really slow. And then they finally catch up to these people, and they kill them with a knife. I'm just thinking, why don't people have guns? I mean,
guns are not, must be, you know, Chicago. First of all, guns are, not everyone has a gun. Most people, I would say, don't have a gun. And then, you know.
But if you're going someplace, and if you're going to stay in the woods for a week.
It's the same reason.
College kids don't have guns. But it's the same reason why
you don't put a lot of black people in a horror films. The same reason why you don't give people guns. If you put a lot of black people in the horror film, there is no horror film because the black guys are leaving after the opening credits. That's number one. Number two, if everybody had a gun, they would kill the bad guy immediately.
Right. Well, that's, I understand, and it wouldn't be a movie. That's right. What
I'm saying. Exactly.
But to me, I just keep thinking when I watch the movie, it's like, okay, it's like, you know, it's been terrible. It's been terrible. I mean, I saw it with The Blair Witch, which I think was a horrible, horrible movie.
That was a great film.
It was good?
It was a great
film. To me, it's like they're going into the woods looking for witches. And I'm like, how come nobody's bringing a gun? And people are saying to me, well, they're going in there looking for witches. Witches, you couldn't kill a witch with a gun. And I'm still debating it. Can you kill a witch with a gun or not? But my point is, it wasn't a witch or a ghost or a demon or anything like that that killed them. It was some crazy psychopath living in the woods.
You don't know that.
I believe that's what the story told.
That's not what the story told.
I thought there was a human beings. I would like to see.
Why was the guy standing in the corner? Well, he wasn't jacking off in the corner at the end of the film.
No, he was just dead, wasn't he?
He wasn't dead. He was standing up.
I just think that if someone had had a gun in that movie or a freaking GPS, I mean, that they could have survived.
You know what I really hate in those horror films? Like, you ever see, everybody saw this one. It's a great 80s film, Monster Squad. I'll never forget when you see a monster coming at you, or you see a guy, just a regular guy. You shoot him, and he doesn't die,
and then you keep shooting.
Right. Like, yeah, I don't know, or worse, you throw the gun and charge him.
Yeah, I never got that, man. It's like, when they shoot Superman.
That'll do it.
Why would you shoot somebody and then throw the gun at them?
Right, I mean, that's what he didn't die from the bullets, so I'm gonna hit you with the gun.
I think it'd be great if like the guy hit him just in the right spot and knocked him out with the gun. It's like,
well, there you go.
Anyway, we got one more commercial, and
this is Movie Saturday.
Movie Saturday, welcome to. We got Pergolian Associates. All right, it's Adrian E. Hayes, Esquire. All right, this is a great attorney, a great law firm and all that. They sponsor a lot of my stuff and all that. I want to continue to thank them. I got the Forget Work, Let's Ride coming up in June, the June 25th, I believe it is, the end of the month, end of June. It's going pretty good, planning it out. It's holding my spots. Well, listen, Pergolian Associates, call up Adrian E. Hayes, Esquire. It's area code 631-423-7755. Bragolilaw.com. That's BRAGOLI law.com. They specialize in getting old slips and falls and stuff like that. If you hurt yourself, you get into an accident, give them a call, check them out, and they'll see what they can do to help you out. And let them know LJ sent you from the Oh Yeah Show, and thank them for their sponsorship and their support. And I guess, you know, we got a few more minutes here.
What else we got?
What else we got? What was it that, I mean, I'm not a big sports guy.
Oh, Pineda.
What's the guy he had the
Pineda.
Stuff
on his neck Pineda,
on?
Yes.
I mean,
the pine tar guy.
Basically, he's just, that's cheating. I mean, he's, so it makes it so you can throw
no,
the ball?
No, wait, I don't know if it's cheating, and I'll explain why.
Okay, I don't know. I don't know.
Every pitcher in baseball uses it.
Oh,
and then the catchers also use it. Now, this is the thing, though. There's something called gentleman cheating. Which basically is everyone knows you're doing it. You just don't throw it out there.
You don't boast about it.
You know what I mean? It's sort of like, you know, if your wife is like, yeah, I know you're cheating. As long as you don't put it in front of my face, I don't see it. You stay alive. It's the same thing with this. Every pitcher does it, especially on cold nights. It helps you with the grip. The catchers keep it underneath their shin guard. So if
really?
You watch, yeah. So everybody, Major League Baseball knows this. The problem with this guy, two things. The first time he did it, he had enough of it on his hand where literally, if he jacked off, he wouldn't. His penis
so
would have been
too much.
His penis would have been surgically implanted on his palm. Now, the Red Sox let him go the first time. They saw it. They were like, "Okay, everybody does it. We'll let it go." But he did it again, and this time he put a glob on it on his neck.
I saw that. I saw it on his neck. Like,
it just doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense.
You know, there's cheating. Like I said, I mean, there's cheating, and they're just going too far. I mean. I don't know. People just go too far. Like I said, I'm not.
Excuse me.
You know, I don't watch baseball a bunch and all that. I mean, so I don't know what's right, what's wrong. I think it's kind of like, you know, remember Mike Tyson when he bit the guy's ear? He bit his ear off.
Evander Holyfield, you know? Yeah.
But, I mean, I guess Evander Holyfield had been doing a couple of moves that would headbutt.
He was headbutting.
Like that. And I guess a common practice, like people said Mike Tyson was a savage, but I guess it's common practice to actually bite someone's ear, not off, but it's a common thing, like when someone's doing stuff like that, You cheat back, you know.
And you know what? To be fair, Mike Tyson was a very great technical boxer. What happened was his feelings, though, he allowed himself to access his feelings and act primally off those feelings. You know what
that's
I'm saying?
That's because of Robin, man. I'm telling you.
I know. Robin messed him up. Robin
messed him up.
Then this coach who he had for years, he was very close, like a father figure, he died.
Messed him up.
Yeah, so I messed them up.
But in everything that we do, there's an acceptable amount of cheating. And what you have to understand is that you have to do it with respect. And you just can't throw a glob of pine tar on your neck.
I don't know why his teammates didn't say, you know, that's
pretty
obvious there. It's pretty obvious. You want to tone that down?
That's what I'm saying, dude. Nobody saw. You know, what is this, dude?
Oh, they think, it's just a black guy. You know, he's got some shit. Yeah,
he's sweating.
He's sweating.
Yeah, you don't want to say nothing.
Oh, my God.
We say something, maybe it's gel or something like that.
Oh,
right?
It's terrible. I was so embarrassed. Yeah. I was so embarrassed. That's my team.
And your team,
yeah? Oh, yeah, I love the Yankees.
Yeah, it was bad. It was bad, bro. Yeah.
Yep, it is a certain amount, but
it's a crazy world out there, man. We're living in. I mean, I don't know. Just so much going on, and you know, I don't know. I mean, I think we're pretty close to the end of the show. I think we got a few more minutes, but I just want to let everybody know out there. You know, listen, we're still looking for sponsors. Always looking for sponsors.
Yes, we are.
And you know, listen, we need one or two more, and we'll get going on that. I mean, listen, give a call. Check me out on Facebook, facebook.com/ American Biker X, and check it out there.
Any bike events going on?
A lot of things going on in the near future. I mean, we got the chili contest this week, the 81 chili contest.
Where's that?
That is in, people can go to Hempstead, go there. I mean, you can look it up. But it's also going to end Mixed Bloodlines Clubhouse, and we're going to wrap it up here. So, I know, we'll just wrap it up for a little. I'm telling to wrap it up. We're done here, I think.
You've heard women tell you that before. Wrap it up.
Yeah, right.
Wrap it up. Come on.
Is that when you get the tap on the shoulder?
Yeah.
Okay.
The music. Like the music.
So she's laughing.
Wrap it up. Wrap it up.
Yeah, you get the tap on the shoulder. All right.
Unless anything said, anybody else got any more news here? No.
No,
I think.
Oh, wait. So what about the wormhole?
Well, first of all, I got people who are really upset when I talked about the wormhole. I'm glad you brought it up.
Yeah, I remember that. You were telling me.
Now listen, you know, the wormhole thing, like I said before, it was kind of like, you know, it was just a theory thrown out there. This is a show for entertainment. And just because I say something doesn't mean I believe it 100%. It's, you know.
God forbid.
It's you know, listen, it's, you know, it's also a little bit of humor. Do I think wormholes don't exist? I think wormholes do exist. Do I think the plane absolutely went into a wormhole? No. But I think something weird happened here. Something different. We don't know what it is. They still haven't found that plane. Have they even found anything?
No debris.
No debris.
Nothing.
They said they found the box. They thought they found the box, and they didn't find the box.
Anything.
So, I mean, listen, I mean,
what are we
it
going
just
on,
disappeared.
Months?
Yeah, 2 months now.
Almost,
I mean,
almost 2 months. The battery on that black box is dead by now.
Right.
It's only got 30
right?
days.
Right.
And they're still sending out the sonar to try and pick up the ping.
I don't get it.
I mean, and there's no debris. Not a thing. Even at 27,000 feet, if this thing's dead, things float. Parts of planes float. Bodies float. Nothing.
Yeah.
Not a thing. I still think that plane is in Pakistan or somewhere. I don't think it went down. They have no proof.
Like I said, the wormhole theory was a little, it was just kind of half a joke, But I mean, I don't know. I mean, more than likely, it was taken. But if it was taken, did they just kill the people? Are the people hostages? What is going on?
Could very well be.
They say, the whole thing they were saying is like Snowden, when the guy who took all the secrets and all that and disappeared,
right.
And then he came out publicly. They say, listen, they could ping someone's cell phone anywhere on this planet, no problem.
Right.
So you had 200 or 300 people on this
plane. If they remember on takeoff, everybody shuts their their phones off, and if those phones are confiscated as soon as those things are off. And nobody gets a chance to power it on.
You know, we opened the show. I think we're going to do a background check on you, bro. I think you know a little
Listen,
bit too
I'm
much.
Just a smart dude, man.
I
don't let them
know
you.
A little bit too much,
I'm
bro.
A smart dude. Listen.
I don't know.
You've never been on a plane?
Of course.
Okay, when you're taking off, they tell you to shut your phone off?
Yeah, but I don't.
I don't. Who does that?
I don't listen.
Majority of the people. The 99%.
I need my phone.
Is that good? The 99% of us turn the phone off.
What gets me, though, man, is how come planes don't have Wi-Fi on them yet? Do they have
Yes,
Wi-Fi?
They do. The new ones, yes. They started, they started
right,
to. Listen, people shut their phones off. Give me a phone. They confiscate all the phones. Nobody has
the
any
terrorists
phones now.
The terrorists would confiscate.
Terrorists. Whoever took over the plane confiscates all the phones. There goes your pinging any of the phones. They're either destroyed, they're shut off, the batteries are taken out, whatever it is, you can't ping any phones. So now what? You're looking for a plane. They turn off the transponders. There was one report that said that they went west, and they were off the coast of Africa or something. They went westbound. Not that they turned and they went south, that they actually went west. And it was a satellite that had a ping off the African coast somewhere, or the Indian coast, or wherever it was. And I'm telling you, within the flight range,
I'm wondering if we'll ever know.
2,500 miles, you could be in Pakistan, you could be in Iran, it could be. There's so many places that this plane could be. You could just land it at the middle of the night, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm telling you.
Listen, everybody, want to thank you all for tuning in, and we are wrapping the show up. I want to thank Lorenzo for coming down this week again, and Preach, as always, good to have you here, man. And
likewise, brother.
I'll talk to everybody. Soon, like I said, we got the 81 chili cook-off and Thunder Run. So check out my page if you want more information and all that. And I'll see you tomorrow. Oh, yeah.
Take care.
Yeah.
That plane...